radon is actually the second leading cause of lung cancer. It's the leading cause of lung cancer in non-smokers, so it's a significant health concern, obviously. It is a concern for not just homeowners, but pretty much anybody who lives inside a home. Any home could have a radon problem, so that would be rental properties as well. So radon is a naturally occurring radioactive gas. It comes out of the ground. It's a natural part of our environment. You'll actually find radon gas in the outdoor air as well, so it's everywhere. It's all around us. The problem is when it comes up through the ground and builds the dangerous levels in our homes. So this doesn't happen to every house. It happens to certain houses that tend to be in certain geological areas, or geographic areas. And different house conditions also play into this. So the radon gas is actually drawn into our house because of pressure differences. So our homes are under negative pressure. It pulls radon gas from the soil and basically lets it build up in the home. The only way to know if radon gas is actually in your home is to test for it. It's invisible, colorless, odorless, tasteless. You can't tell if it's there by our senses. So the only way to know if it's actually there is to test for it. So radon is coming from the ground and it's heavier than air. So you'll tend to find higher concentrations in lower levels in the home. So if you have a basement, that's usually where you'll find the highest levels. However, the recommendation is to test your lowest living area. So if your basement is used for storage or for laundry, then you really don't spend that much time down there. It may seem like you're doing a lot of laundry, but it's not as much time as you're actually spending in your living room or your bedroom. So you want to test your lowest living area. So if, again, that basement is just for storage, test your living room, your bedroom. That's where you're actually spending the most time. We have a good idea of some of the hot spots around the state, but there are a lot of areas where we just don't have enough test data, so we don't necessarily know. We know that the Portland area, for one example, does have a higher potential for radon. We do have a lot of test data for that particular area. Other parts of the state, there have been some pockets. So La Grande, we found some pretty high levels as well. The Salem area, we found some high levels. It does kind of pop around the state. If you look at a map of the entire state, it's kind of hit or miss all around the state. So what we're really pushing for is to get more testing done so we have a better understanding as to where the higher potential areas are. So most folks test their homes themselves. The first time around, they'll go out and actually buy a radon test kit. They vary in price, but average price is around $15. This is an example of what they would look like. It's just a small envelope. Basically, they'll send this to you in the mail, or you can pick it up at a local hardware store. What you do is just record the start and stop time of the test. You let this hang in your living room or bedroom or there, whatever area you're testing. You need to sit in place for at least 48 hours. Most test kit manufacturers recommend between 3 to 5 days. After that time frame, you record the stop time, you seal it up, you send it off to the laboratory, and they'll send you your results, and you'll usually get them in about a week. So it's a pretty quick turnaround time. Short-term tests are what most folks start with because it's quick. Gives you a quick result. They're relatively inexpensive. Test kits are basically broken down into two categories, short-term tests and long-term tests. Short-terms are anywhere from 48 hours up to 90 days. Long-term tests are 91 days up to a year, and they both have pros and cons. So the short-term tests are good because they're quick and they're cheap. Long-term tests, they're going to give you a much more accurate reading. It's going to take all of those variations from high and low radon concentrations in your home and average it into one number. So long-term tests are more reliable. Short-term tests are not as reliable, but they're inexpensive and quick. So there's some trade-offs for both of them. So that's the best part of this. Radon problems can be fixed. What most folks will do is contact a radon professional. There are mitigation companies that can come out and actually mitigate your home. So what that means is basically venting that radon gas out from underneath your home to the outdoors. So if you have a basement, they'll put a small plastic pipe through your foundation floor. They'll run that pipe either up through the house or out the side of the house to the roof line. And a fan draws air from underneath the house and vents it outside. So you're kind of changing that pressure difference between the soil and the house itself. For a crawl space, it'd be a similar scenario. They put down plastic sheeting, and they seal that plastic all together and to the perimeter and any support pilings that might be underneath there. And then they draw air from underneath the plastic sheet and vent it outside. So basically, you're capturing any soil gas that's coming up and venting it outside so it doesn't have a chance to get drawn into your home. So we have lots of information about radon on our website. That's www.healthoregon, H-E-A-L-T-H, Oregon spelled out, O-R-E-G-O-N, .org, O-R-G, /radon.